after Pope Francis's January trip to the Philippines, where he made calls to protect children. A U.S.-based watchdog group released a report claiming children in the Philippines may not be safe from priests who are documented offenders. They are now calling on the Vatican and Philippine church and government officials to look into the way the legal system deals with these clergy members.
You know, he spoke about the suffering of children when he was in the Philippines. And that's one reason why we are asking Pope Francis to intervene as well. You know, he cannot change the economic inequities that prevail in the Philippines and the United States and in so many countries that cause children to suffer. The suffering of children is being deepened by Filipino bishops who keep abusers in ministry.
The group claims that their research has found at least a dozen Catholic priests in the Philippines who have been linked to child abuse cases in the U.S., and yet they continue to serve in the Philippines despite recommendations and warnings from U.S. church officials. They say the accused priests are being shielded by local bishops, and for one reason or another, had been able to avoid prosecution in the U.S.
So there's an impunity for Catholic bishops and religious supervisors that's built into the legal infrastructure of the Philippines that is allowing abusers to stay in ministry and subjecting children to harm.
One of the cases can be traced back some 30-plus years to a Southern California church. For the victim, the possibility that one of her abusers is still an active priest in the Philippines is disturbing. This is Rita Mila, a California woman abused by seven Filipino priests as a teenager in the 1980s. Mila was impregnated by one of the priests and gave birth in the Philippines. She eventually won a settlement, with some of the priests apologizing.
It worries me a lot because that means that more than likely they're still doing the same thing.
Bishop Accountability has sent the report to the Catholic Bishops Conference in the Philippines, as well as several Philippine government agencies, calling for them to look into these priests. They also sent the report to Gabriel Dailiaco, who has been named to the Pontifical Commission for the Protection of Minors. They are hoping he could bring up the issues of abusive clergy and the Philippines' lack of regulation to the Vatican.
We hope that he really generates some change and some improvements, specifically around the area of holding bishops accountable.
Since he's educated and more open, he should be able to see things as they really are.
Pope Francis has reiterated the need for bishops to be accountable in sex abuse cases, with officials from the CBCP publicly welcoming the Pope's initiatives to further protect children. Steve Angelus, ABS-CBN News, Carson, California.